We're getting closer to the end of this penultimate lap. He'll just have 1 4-kilometre long lap to go.
Ayagura then, he's desperately trying to get a two-bike slipstream here behind Arbolino and Garcia. He needs a podium, desperate for a podium to really punish Albert Arenas' poor day. The gap between Fernandez and Arbolino then was 1.4 seconds. Surely Fernandez won't fluff his lines now.
Through goes Garcia, a twitch from Arbolino, and here comes Ayagura then. He's surely going to try and challenge into turn two. These two are weaving around. Garcia then moves up into second. In the meantime, Raul Fernandez should be home and dry. What a brilliant race it has been for the number 25. But can Ayagura get himself into second place? Can he even get up a place at all? Is he going to be on the podium?
Well, Garcia can go for this, can't he? He's got nothing to lose, win it or bin it. That's what he'll probably do, because he's got absolutely nothing to fight for in the championship. He can take more risks than Arbolino. Agüero behind him, ruthless by Agüero. That's brilliant. He's picked the pocket of Arbolino there at turn six. And as he snatched the podium late on here in Valencia.
Precious points here for both of these guys in the World Championship. One thing they cannot afford to do, of course, is end up in a gravel trap.
He's come down to 1.1 seconds. We thought Garcia was going to go for it. Has he got anything left? Is he running out of time? It looks like he's broken away from Agüero and Arbolino. 1.1 seconds he's got to bridge to Fernandez.
Arbolino's really, really hungry here to try and challenge Ayagura again and find himself on the podium. You just think here, what would have happened if Garcia had gone through a little sooner?
Yeah, he's going to run out of time. Fernandez, the gap now has come down to under a second for the first time in an awful long time. But Fernandez, it's his to lose now. He's going to be able to manage quite comfortably that advantage of 9 tenths.
Coming into
final sector.
It's all out attack here. Ayagura, I thought, was going to try and lunge.
He ran a tight defensive line, but it's been fabulous. Fernandez in Valencia, what a ride.
What a win, a maiden victory for Raul Fernandez in Moto3. Garcia comes across the line to take second place, his first podium in a year, and Ayagura is back on the podium, and the championship is well alive. Here's Darren Binder. He just holds on to fifth place across the line ahead of Carlos Tatay. Alcoba's in seventh, Nepa in eighth, Zalac ninth, and it looks like Sasaki in tenth. What a win, though, for the Red Bull KTM Iho rider. Brilliant, brilliant result for him. His second podium, his first win in Grand Prix racing.
Yeah, I think it's fair to say it's fantastic and phenomenal. Fernandez did not put a foot wrong in that race, got a lead of up to 3 seconds, and then managed it brilliantly in the second half of the race. Crucial last lap that was by Ayagura, wasn't it? Aggressive move up the inside of Tony Arbolino at turn six. There's Celestino Vietti. It's been a poor day at the office for him. He's going to limp over the line in 23rd place. He caused all the drama early on, didn't he, with the big high side? Then Arenas checked, and he got hit then by Alonso Lopez. That cost Albert Arenas crucial World Championship points. Massia and McPhee were down. And when all said and done, Ayagura takes a crucial podium, which keeps him right in championship contention. But Arenas, incredibly, is coming back here in Valencia in 7 days' time to defend a 3-point lead in the championship, despite a no score today.
Yeah, it's not comfortable though, is it? Not anymore.